Carlos, that was a great song. I think we can use it this week in our Bible story. Let's see, with our Bible story. Where was I? Whoa, you snuck up on me. I was actually just getting our flannel board story ready, and I was looking up some places in the Bible where Jesus appears to his disciples after he rose from the dead. Let me get the flannel board so you can see it better, okay? Hold on. All right, we'll move it here. You have to tell me, is that good? Is that good? All right, let's see if we can. All right, there we go. All right, where were we? Okay, so when I looked up in the Bible, I looked in the Gospel of Luke. See, I highlighted some of the words there to help me remember what to read. Okay, let's see. It says, on the road to Emmaus. Well, Emmaus was about 7 miles west of Jerusalem. Boy, that's a long walk. But you know what? People walked all over the place back then. They didn't have cars. That's right. So there was these two men walking. Here, let me put them on the board. They were walking. And they were talking the whole way. You know what they were talking about? All the things that had taken place in Jerusalem this past week. Jesus died on the cross. He was crucified. And then he was buried. And then they said these women went to the tomb and said they saw angels, but they couldn't find his body. And so they were just talking away. And then you know what happened? Another man came up next to them. It was actually Jesus, but they didn't know it was him. They didn't recognize him at all. And so he asked, he says, what are you guys talking about? What is it you're talking about? So they said, this one Cleopas says to him, he says, are you the only visitor in Jerusalem that doesn't know what's happened? And he says, well, and Jesus said, well, what things have happened? So, well, let's just read it right out of the Bible, those highlighted words that I wrote. Cleopas says, concerning Jesus of Nazareth, a man who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death, and he died, he crucified on the cross. But we had hoped that he was the one that would save Israel. And do you know what Jesus said? He said, oh, slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? And then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he began to help them understand the scriptures of what it said about Jesus. Well, it was getting late, and they were getting closer to the village. And so the men urged Jesus, oh, please stay with us and have a meal. They had urged Jesus, come and stay with us. And as you can see, they're sitting at the table, and he did come and stay with them. But it was getting late, remember? You can even see the stars coming out. Look at them. Well, if they're going to have dinner together, we better set the table. Let's give them their drinks, one for each of them. And we'll put the food on the table. A basket over here and some food. Oh, we can't forget the bread. And Jesus blessed the bread. And he broke it. And he gave it to each of them. And when he did, they recognized that it was Jesus. And then he vanished. He was gone. And the men said, didn't our hearts burn within us when he shared with us along the road and opened up the scriptures to us? At that very same hour, these two men, they left. They went back to Jerusalem to find those 11 disciples and to tell them all that had happened and that they had seen Jesus and that they had recognized him in the breaking of the bread They knew it was Jesus. Do you know who Jesus is? Jesus is the Son of God. He came from heaven to earth. He lived a perfect life. He died on the cross to pay for our sins. He rose from the dead. He's in heaven now, preparing a place for us. Let's pray. Dear God, help me to know who Jesus is. Help me to recognize who he is. Amen. There are many other times in the Bible where it is recorded that Jesus appeared to his disciples in his resurrected body. You find it in the Gospels and also in the book of Acts. But On the Road to Emmaus is very special because when Jesus walks with these men, he begins to explain to them why the Savior had to suffer. You see, these men had their mind thinking that the Savior would come and conquer the Romans so that Israel would have peace. But that wasn't the kind of peace that Jesus came to bring us. He came to bring us peace with God, peace with God the Father, that we wouldn't have to be punished for our sins. So we're going to take a look at Isaiah. In fact, I'm going to ask Isaiah to share with us a little bit out of the scripture, out of Isaiah chapter 53, to maybe help us to understand a little bit more the suffering servant that Jesus was. Shalom. My name is Isaiah. I was a prophet hundreds of years before Jesus was even born. And I spoke about a Savior that would come. God had given me these words. Let me read to you out of my scroll. Isaiah 53:3-5. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, and as one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace. And with his stripes, we are healed. Lots of big words, right? Jesus was hated. People hid their faces from him. Yet Jesus carried our sins and sorrows. God the Father punished sins. He punished Jesus for our sins. He was wounded with whips. People spat at him. They called him names. They pressed a crown of thorns in his head. And they nailed him to a cross for him to die. Why? It was the punishment that Jesus took to buy us peace with God. You say, why? Do you remember? What is God like? Buddy and I are going to try to do this one together because we have to keep our social distancing. So just the two of us are going to do it, okay? So let's give it a try. Perhaps you can do it with us. God, put your hands way up high. Buddy has a short arm. God is holy, loving, and just. On the one hand, God loves us and doesn't want to punish us. But on the other hand, God is just and must punish sin. Do you see the problem? God solved this problem by sending who? By sending Jesus. That's right. Why in the world do we have a problem with sin anyway? Well, we've got to go back to the beginning of the Bible and take a look where sin came from. So, where did sin come from? Well, we're going to look to the Bible, God's Word, right in the beginning, in the book of Genesis. That's the first book. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And that's not all he created. He created everything on earth. That's right, the dogs and the trees and the flowers and man. God made man special. God made man and woman in his image. Man walked and talked with God in the garden. They were friends. But then along came Satan, and man fell into sin, and that sin separated them from God. Oh, they would have to leave that beautiful garden. But before they even left, God promised that one day he would send a Savior. That's right. And the prophets of old wrote about him for hundreds of years, and they told all about this suffering servant, this Savior who would come and take the punishment for our sins, for those who would believe and trust in the Savior. But sins, what are sins anyway? Sins are anything we think, we say, we do, or we don't do that displeases God. And since we were born with a sinful nature, that's like we're our parents are Adam and Eve, so we have that same sinful nature too. We're not sinners because we sin. We sin because we are sinners. And everybody needs a Savior. We have all fallen short of God's glory. That means we do not follow the commandments all the time. We're not perfect, are we? So God sent his son Jesus to pay the price for sin. The penalty for sin is death. That's right. That's what he told Adam and Eve before they ate from that tree. He said, don't turn your back on me, because if you do, the punishment is death. But before they even left the garden, remember, he said, I promise that I will send a Savior. We read from the prophets that this Savior is Jesus, and that he would have to suffer and die. And that's what he was sharing with the men on the road to Emmaus. But they still didn't realize it was Jesus until he blessed and broke the bread. And then they recognized who he was. I am praying that you'll recognize who Jesus is. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for sending Jesus, who died on the cross to pay for my sins, Lord God, that I can have peace with you. I know that he is in heaven now, and he's preparing a place for me and for all those who will trust in what Jesus did on the cross. Amen.
In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation. We believe generation. When all is dark, you help us see. There is only one salvation. We believe, we believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and he's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that he conquered death. We believe in the resurrection, and he's coming back again. We believe. So faith be more than anthems, greater than the songs we sing. And in our weakness and temptations, Spirit.